Are you looking for the best editing software for PC in 2024? We've done a ton of testing and we've narrowed it down to our top two options. So whether you're looking for a beginner-friendly and free Windows video editor or something more advanced and something more powerful, then I've got some great options for you. So when we're creating these videos, it's always a really tough call because there's so many different options out there. But these two tools, these two options I've got for you are going to be great for the vast majority of you out there. And both of these options also have great free and watermark free versions as well. So the first option is CapCut. CapCut is an amazing video editing tool. It's great for a beginner right through to someone at an intermediate level because it's so simple to use. It's so intuitive. It's got a really amazing interface that makes it easy for someone who is an absolute beginner to jump in to get up to speed, but also for someone who's an intermediate level user, there is a bunch of effects and transitions and everything in there to help you create something amazing fast. It also works on nearly everything. There is a Windows version, a Mac version, iOS and Android, and you can even transfer your projects between the different devices using their cloud backup service. There are so many different effects and transitions and animations built in with a good level of customization or control to get everything looking the way that you'd like. The overall editing experience is fast, it's fluid, it's easy to edit in. And if video creation is easy, then you're probably going to have more fun creating videos. Now they've also got a built-in stock media library, which has music, stickers, sound effects that's built into CapCut as well. And it's nice that it's in there, but what I recommend that you use instead is services like Storyblocks or Motion Array for motion graphics, or Artlist or Epidemic Sound for music and for sound effects. So that way you know that you're not going to have any copyright issues or legal issues with stuff that you create later. Now, one thing I love about CapCut is it's constantly evolving, probably more so than any other tool out there. They're constantly updating and adding new stuff. I swear most times I open it up, there's some sort of new update ready to go. And I love that because it's really putting CapCut at the bleeding edge of what people want. There's a lot of trending stuff in there as well for creating TikTok videos, shorts, reels, but they're also evolving the core feature set as well, making it easier and easier for you to create stuff fast. It's also probably got the most amount of AI video tools integrated in there right now. Things like AI color grading, captions, voiceovers, even AI presenters or avatars. So for those of you that are looking to create faceless channels, then there's some great stuff in there for you too. They've also now got a text-based editing feature as well, where you can edit your video down like you would a Word document or a Google Doc, similar to tools like Descript, but built directly into CapCut. There's also a great cloud-based workflow now too, whether it's for transferring files or projects between different devices, or even working collaboratively with team or with people remote. And what you'll find is a lot of the core functionality and the stuff that you'll be using day in, day out in CapCut is actually free. And that's where the free option of CapCut is so powerful. I know so many people that are using CapCut, most of them are on the free version. Now, it wasn't that long ago that it was totally free and that everything was included for free, but they are now moving more and more features and effects and things over to the pro or the paid version of CapCut, which is still ridiculously cheap considering what you're getting access to. So right now, the paid pro version is gonna cost you $7.99 per month or $74.99 for the year. So if you do find that you wanna unlock those pro features, then that's all it's gonna cost you. And if you are on the free version, you can clearly see which features are included in free, which ones are marked as pro. You can even demo them so you can use them in your projects to test them out, but you just can't have them in your project if you're on the free version when you go to export, or that's where it is going to add a watermark to your video. So if you are on the free version, you want to make sure that you haven't used any of those pro features or pro effects in your edit when you go to export. But I also love that on the free version, you don't even need to create a free CapCut account or to sign in. You can literally just download and install this without even needing to create an account. Now, it's also worth noting that CapCut isn't available everywhere. There are some countries out there that have restricted access to it because it's owned by the company ByteDance, which is the same company that owns TikTok. So I guess there could be some data or privacy concerns there. But for me personally, I really don't see that as a concern. But if you are looking for an alternative, a different option to CapCut, then I'd say check out Filmora. And again, we'll have links down in the description below. So that's option number one, CapCut. But for those of you that are looking looking for something more advanced and really pro level, then that's where it's hard to go past DaVinci Resolve. And I'd say that this one is definitely suited for people at that intermediate to advanced user, but that's because this is literally pro grade software. So it is going to be more complicated to use. It is going to take you longer to get up to speed, especially if you've never used a tool like this before. But there's also the next level of features, the next level of control and creative ability that you can have in here. And once you've mastered it, this is going to be such a powerful tool and so fast to edit in. But it's also not just editing software. It's more of a production suite than just an editing tool. It's actually multiple tools in one. So Resolve really breaks everything down into workflow-based pages, they call them. So there's a page for ingesting and logging your footage. There's a page for cutting it down, doing some basic edits. There is a full editing page, and this is where I spend most of my time. There's also one for motion graphics and animation. There's one for sound production. There's one for color grading, and there's one for export or for delivery. And a lot of these really are essentially their own apps, their own professional grade software that's built into Resolve. So the audio production tool, Fairlight, is literally pro grade software. Fusion is really DaVinci Resolve's answer to Adobe After Effects. And the color page is something that a lot of films and a lot of documentaries and TV shows, whether they've been edited in DaVinci Resolve or on other pro tools, a lot of people are bringing their edits and their projects into this color page here in Resolve to finish them, to apply a different look or feel to their edit. DaVinci Resolve is also cross-platform, so it works on Windows, it works on Mac, it works on Linux, and there's also an iPad version as well. That is a little restricted, the iPad version. It's not the same as the desktop, but we're hoping, fingers crossed, that they port over the whole thing very soon. But DaVinci Resolve also includes a lot of different effects and templates and things that you can use, literally drag and drop them onto your timeline. But because the software is so popular, you can also easily find next level templates on places like Video Hive or Motion Array, or you can even create your own effects and transitions and things using the built-in Fusion tool too. And again, this is another tool I'd say is leading the way in terms of integrating AI and video editing as well, with a text-based editing feature too, video upscaling, background noise removal, voice isolation for enhancing your audio. But they also have an amazing cloud-based workflow in here too, where you're not just sharing projects between computers or between people, but also allows you to work collaboratively on the same project and in real time too. They also have a huge range of supported hardware options too. Again, this stuff is aimed more at the serious, more at the pro users, but they can be great to help you speed up and streamline your creation process too. But overall, it's just an absolute beast of a program. So while I've been an editor on Final Cut Pro and Adobe Premiere Pro for years, and even Avid before that, this is now my top pick for those looking for this pro grade software like this. And again, there's also a great free version of it, giving you access to a lot of the core functionality with very little restrictions and no watermark. But for those of you who want to unlock everything, unlock greater level of performance and hardware integration, videos that are higher than 4K resolution, but also unlock all of the effects and functionality, then that's where you'll want to be on their studio version, which is a one-time purchase, so not a monthly subscription. It's a one-time purchase of $295. Again, ridiculously cheap considering what you're getting access to. So if you're interested in checking these out, you can easily jump on the free versions of either one of them, test them out. If the pro versions or the studio version is a fit for you, then that's the time to upgrade. But for those of you who want to find out more about CapCut or DaVinci Resolve, we've got a bunch of tutorials and resources linked in the description box below, including our free video editing guide. It's a totally free PDF download, which takes you through the ultimate video editing process, helping you edit more efficiently in any app or tool. So definitely check out the description, and I will see you in the next video.